The Schienenzeppelin or Rail Zeppelin was an experimental railcar which resembled a Zeppelin airship in appearance. It was designed and developed by the German aircraft engineer Franz Kruckenberg in 1929. Franz Friedrich Kruckenberg was an engineer and pioneer of high-speed railway systems. Later, together with Hermann Fadinger, he founded the Flugbahn-Gesellschaft MBH to build a high-speed propeller-driven train, the Schienenzeppelin. Between Ludwigslust and Wittenberg, the Schienenzeppelin achieved a world speed record for trains of 230.2 km per hour. Kruckenberg rebuilt the Schienenzeppelin to a hydraulically driven car, which still had a top speed of 180 km per hour with only 441 kilowatts. The Schienenzeppelin was revolutionary for its time, since the aerodynamic streamline profile and the lightweight design were proven as feasible features for high-speed railways. While Kruckenberg's ideas continue to influence high-speed train design today, the Schienenzeppelin was scrapped in 1939. Propulsion was by means of a pusher propeller located at the rear. It accelerated the railcar to 230.2 km per hour, setting the land speed record for a petrol-powered rail vehicle. Only a single example was ever built, which due to safety concerns remained out of service and was finally dismantled in 1939. Anticipating the design of the Schienenzeppelin, the earlier Aerowagon, an experimental Russian high-speed railcar, was also equipped with an aircraft engine and a propeller. The railcar was built at the beginning of 1930 in the Hanover Leinhausen works of the German Imperial Railway Company. The vehicle was 25.85 meters long and had just two axles, with a wheelbase of 19.6 meters. As originally built, it had two conjoined BMW IV six-cylinder petrol aircraft engines, fixed-pitch ash propeller. The driveshaft was raised 7 degrees above the horizontal to give the vehicle some downwards thrust. The body of the Schienenzeppelin was streamlined, having some resemblance to the era's popular Zeppelin airships, and it was built of aluminum in aircraft style to reduce weight. The railcar could carry up to 40 passengers. Its interior was Spartan and designed in Bauhaus style. On the 10th of May 1931, the Schienenzeppelin exceeded a speed of 200 km per hour for the first time. It was exhibited to the general public throughout Germany. On the 21st of June 1931, it set a new world railway speed record of 230.2 km per hour on the Berlin-Hamburg line between Karstadt and Durgenthin, which was not surpassed by any other rail vehicle until 1954. The railcar still holds the land speed record for a petrol-powered rail vehicle. This high speed was attributable, amongst other things, to its low weight, which was only 20.3 tons. In 1932, Kruckenberg began a new project with the railcar involving significant modifications. It was cut just behind the forward wheels and received a complete new front end with a two-axle bogie, resembling the later 137,155 railcar. The aircraft engine was still used, however, the power transmission was hydraulic through two Fadinger fluid drives for both directions of travel, fitted on the forward bogie. A pointed fairing was installed in place of the propeller. The resulting vehicle was a B1 with a powered front bogie. This version of the vehicle reached 180 km per hour at the beginning of 1933. Due to many problems with the Schienenzeppelin prototype, the Deutsche Reichsbahn-Gesellschaft decided to go their own way in developing a high-speed railcar, leading to the Fliegender Hamburger in 1933. This new design was suitable for regular service and served also as the basis for later railcar developments. Many of the Kruckenberg ideas, based on the experiments with Schienenzeppelin and high-speed rail travel, found their way into later DRG railcar designs. At the beginning of 1934, the Schienenzeppelin was rebuilt for the last time, and a Maybach Go 5 engine was installed. In July 1934, it was sold to Deutsche Reichsbahn for 10,000 Reichsmarks. 5 years later, in 1939, the Rail Zeppelin was finally dismantled because its material was needed by the German army. The failure of Schienenzeppelin has been attributed to everything from the dangers of using an open propeller in crowded railway stations to fierce competition between Kruckenberg's company and the Deutsche Reichsbahn's separate efforts to build high-speed railcars. One disadvantage of the Rail Zeppelin was the inherent difficulty of pulling additional wagons to form a train, because of its construction. The vehicle could not use its propeller to climb steep gradients, as the flow would separate when full power was applied. Thus, an additional means of propulsion was needed for such circumstances. Safety concerns have been associated with running high-speed railcars on old track network, with the inadvisability of reversing the vehicle, and with operating a propeller close to passengers.